Brother Nuri just made the comparison between Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam and Mawla Husayn alayhi salam. It is interesting as poets how we make comparisons between the tragedies that befell the Ahlul Bayt and how different personalities endured this. You've heard about how Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam, who was known as the prisoner of Baghdad, met his fate, how his hands were shackled in chains, and how he used to try and peer out of the bars of the prison but was beaten every time he did. Now I just want you to take your mind to another prisoner. Take your minds to Sham, and there's 2 4-year-old wrists that are clenched in chains, that are wrapped in chains. And every time she looks out of that window, she sees the doves flying home, and she says to her aunt, "Oh aunt, when are we going to go home like these doves?" They say that Mawla Hussein's body was left without a shroud. But this 4-year-old girl's body was also left without a shroud. It is said when the Ahlul Bayt, when the ladies of the Ahlul Bayt were giving her ghusl, they screamed and they asked Mawla Sajjad, "Oh Imam, is this young girl ill for some reason?" Mawla said, "Why'd you say that?" They said, "All the skin on her body is a different color. Some of it's yellow, some of it's black, some of it's blue. Is she sick? Does she have fungus growing on her?" Mawla said, "Please don't say that. She's the pure daughter of a pure Imam. You see, Shimmer used to slap her so hard and beat her so hard that all of her skin changed color." Then they asked Mawla, "Mawla, whenever we try and take her clothes off to give her ghusl, we can't do that." Imam said that when we're in the bazaar of Sham, people used to throw things at us. There was a point when a woman stood on the balcony and to take her revenge on our grandfather, she's poured boiling water over our caravan. And it so happened that this young girl was under the boiling water, and it burned her skin in such a way that her clothes and her skin became one. And since then, it's been stuck together. The only thing I ask you is that we say that Mawla Husayn was lonely. We say Imam Musa al-Kadhim was lonely. But in reality, they are buried next to their loved ones. But think about that 4-year-old girl who's in Sham, whose voice you can still hear when you go to do her ziyarat. When she says that this prison is very dark, if you can, just light one candle before you leave. When the Ahlul Bayt returned to Karbala after Sham, it is said that Bibi Zainab, and this is a very strange circumstance, a strange situation. Bibi Zainab, when she came to the grave of her brother, she didn't come walking to the grave. She came crawling on her hands and knees. When you go crawling on your hands and knees to somewhere, it is when you're asking for forgiveness. She must have said to her brother, "Oh brother, on that day of Ashura, you left me with one amana. But I've left that amana in Sham. Please forgive me."
Bhai jaap ko bheja hai, Sakina ne salam, apne ammu ke liye hai, ye bhatiji ka kalam, bujh gayi pyaas shika, yat ka nahi ko hi kala, paani ke vaaste shay milda hai ammu kyun kar maaf karna mujhe maaf karna chhod kar aayi hu zinda mein sakina ko maaf karna mujhe maaf karna pursalo apni sakina ka mere maa jaye jisko armaan tha usko hi nahi la paaye. Ghar chalo kehti rahi aakhri dam tak haaye. Usko behlaati rahi jaldi chalenge hum ghar. Maaf karna mujhe, maaf karna. Kaun pardes mein hai qabr pe jaane wala. Kaun hai sham dhal sham ma jalane wala. Koi hamdard nahi gham ka batane wala. Mere maa jaye bahut khai hai humne thokar. Maaf karna mujhe, maaf karna. Nanni si jaan uthai hai jafaye kya kya. Ek sharabi ne kanizi nanni si jaan uthai hai jafaye kya kya. Ek sharabi ne kanizi ke liye jab manga mera sacha bhi hai rat se lahu ro diya tha. Badi hasrat se hame dekh rahi thi muztar. Maaf karna mujhe, maaf karna.
In the courtyard